Media playback is unsupported on your device. Media caption: Conservative Sebastian Kurz, the frontrunner. Austria's Conservative People's Party OVP, led by 31-year-old Sebastian Kurz, is set to win the country's general election, projections suggest. The victory would make Mr. Kurz the world's youngest national leader. The People's Party was set to win 31.5%, followed by the Social Democrats with 27.1% and the far-right Freedom Party FPO with 25.9%. Short of a majority, Mr. Kurz's party could seek an alliance with the FPO, which campaigned against immigration. Who is Sebastian Kurz? Before the election, Mr. Kurz served as Europe's youngest ever foreign minister. After he was appointed in 2013, aged just 27, in May 2017 he became the leader of the OVP. He began his political career in the youth wing of the party, which he chaired before moving on to serve on Vienna's city council. Nicknamed Wonder Wuzzy, roughly translated someone who can walk on water, he has been compared to the young leaders of France and Canada, Emmanuel Macron and Justin Trudeau. Much like Mr. Macron, Mr. Kurz has created a movement around himself, rebranding the OVP, which has been in power for more than 30 years, as the New People's Party. What were the main issues? Immigration was the dominant issue in the run-up to the vote, and Mr. Kurz moved his party to the right in the wake of Europe's 2015 refugee crisis. He appealed to conservative and right-wing voters with pledges to shut down migrant routes to Europe, cap benefit payments to refugees, and bar immigrants from receiving benefits until they have lived in Austria for 5 years. Image copyright Getty Images. Image caption: FPO leader Heinz Christian Strache accuses Mr. Kurz of stealing his policies. The rightward shift was seen as a response to the success of the FPO, which narrowly missed out on the presidency in December when Norbert Hofer was defeated by Alexander van der Bellen, head of the Greens. The stance proved popular with Austrian voters after a huge influx of undocumented migrants and refugees from the Middle East and North Africa. The FPO accused Mr. Kurz of stealing their policies. Their candidate, Heinz Christian Strache, has called him an imposter. What next? Mr. Kurz looks to be on course to win the lion's share of the vote, but not a majority. If the polls are correct, he will need to form a coalition, most likely with the FPO. The last coalition between the Social Democrats and the Conservatives fell apart this spring, and there may be reluctance to renew it. But an alliance with the populist, far-right FPO could prove controversial among Austria's EU counterparts. Polls currently put the FPO at an all-time high of 26.9%, suggesting that the European far-right is not dead after emphatic defeats in France and the Netherlands. The relative success of the FPO follows an electoral breakthrough by the far right in neighboring Germany last month. What about the opposition? The current chancellor, Social Democrat leader Christian Kern, looks certain to lose his position after a campaign marred by several scandals, including allegations that his advisor led an online smear campaign against Mr. Kurz. Mr. Kern said on Sunday he had no intention of standing down as leader, despite the party's loss. "I have said I will stay in politics for 10 years and there are 9 years to go," he told broadcaster OBF. After a tumultuous year with internal rifts, the pro-refugee Greens party is among several smaller parties uncertain of reaching the 4% threshold required to enter parliament.